Hey guys, in this video, we're gonna show you how to assemble your very own set of Head Amame headphones. Before we jump in, I just wanna show off to you guys that we got parts kits on the website. They come with a sticker, and you can also buy all the fasteners individually if you want. Those listings are all live on the website now, so go check them out. We sell the drivers, cables, fasteners, the little rubber bumpers, everything you might need. All right, on to the instructions. So when you're assembling a Head Amame cone, the very first thing that you're gonna wanna do is get the headband mount ready. And that's with this little rubber bumper. You can get that installed to the headband mount here. So you place it in there, and you can get this just started with your fingers. And get down as far as you can. And then, once it starts to get tough, you can use some pliers and just spin the headband mount itself around the rubber bumper. There. So that's ready to go. Next thing to do is place the headband mount inside the cone. And the tough part about this one is you want to make sure that this is straight in the cone before you place it in, because it's very difficult to adjust that after the fact. So you can get it started just part way, just like that. You can see that we've got a little ways to go yet. And push that in, and you, at this point you want to make sure that it's straight before you do that final push in. So that looks pretty good. And push it in just like that, around the edges. Sometimes you gotta push in this part right here. But that's all seated properly. So that's ready to go. And next, we can put on the headband clamp. This is the part that clamps down on the headband to hold it on that rubber bumper and keep your headband adjustment solid. So to do that, you just plug that in the top, just like that, and we've got the dovetail. And then we screw that in with your M3x6 screw. And that fits in just like that. And we use an Allen key to put that in. That's a 2mm Allen key. And you don't want to go overly tight. Just enough so you get a little bit of resistance. That dovetail inside there is going to do most of the work. So now that you have the headband mount and the clamp installed on the cone, you can worry about installing this MiniXLR connector as well. So all you have to do is place that right in the hole. Just like that, make sure it's seated at the bottom. And then we're gonna use this little clip that we printed to hold that tight. If you have a little bit of elephant's foot happening on the clip, you know, the side where the clip was resting on the bed, it's best to put that on the inside of towards the inside of the cone. So if this side of the clip was on the base of the bed of the printer, then we're gonna make sure that heads towards the inside. So get that clip started as far as you can. That's about right, make sure it's straight. The easiest way to make sure this goes in straight and doesn't snap off one way or another is to just put this down on the table and push down, just like that. Sometimes it clicks into place. You can see that's seated nicely into the cone. So we wanted to make sure that we did both of these parts first. Once you put this ear pad mount on, it's impossible to access either of these two spots. Okay, so now that we have the MiniXLR mounted, as well as the spring clamp and all the rest of the parts on the cone, we can worry about mounting the drivers. So in order to mount the driver and the ear pad mount onto the cone, it's easiest if we start off putting the screws into the driver mount through the ear pad mount and then put it on the cone last. So what we're gonna do is just place all our M3x25 screws into the driver, just like this. And then we want to put this mounted onto the flat part of the ear pad mount. And the other thing we want to do is make sure that the fatter side of the driver mount, you can see that we've got kind of a fat side here, that part needs to go forward and it needs to go away from the mounting slot for the ear pads. So once that's done, once the screws are into the driver mount, We can line them up and insert that into the ear pad mount. So we've got all four lined up just like that. And we double check. The VF logo should be near this mounting spot for the ear pad, this little slot. And if you see the if you see some extra holes in here, I'm using some prototype parts for this assembly video. These holes haven't been released yet. We're not happy with the sound. So once we have that all mounted, careful not to lose a screw there. We can worry about getting this attached to the cone. So what we want to do is we want to, it's easiest if you put this on the table. We want to attach the driver into the XLR mount, or into the MiniXLR port. And we're just going to put the red wire to the red wire, black to the black. Easy peasy. Red wire, black wire. And then we want to carefully pick up this whole assembly and make sure that we put this ear pad mounting slot to the rear of the headphone. And that's the side that's away from the MiniXLR mount. So we've given you enough wires to twist that in gently, and you can look underneath to make sure that things are lining up properly and the wires are kind of tucking in nicely. You can see that things seem to be working out nicely here. And we're just going to place the screws into the into each of the holes. Just like that. Look inside, make sure we're not pinching any wires. Looks good. Get those screws as far down as they'll go into the cone. Once you've checked that the ear pad mounting slot is next to the clamp at the back of the cone, you can start fastening the screws. And we want to use a star pattern here. And again, just be careful about using too much force to tighten them up. They're threading into plastic and we've given them a good distance. They're strong, but you need to be careful. And so I'm following this star pattern, doing opposite corners first, and not too tight. I'll finish off the tightening at the end. Get them all seated. And then following that star pattern, just give it a final tighten, and we'll be all ready to go. Once you've done that, you can mount the ear pad. And you just need to slide it on to that slot there and spin it around. And you can see that'll come right around and mount the ear pad. I like to put this seam near the bottom, just like that. And there you go. And if you do that again, you'll wind up with another cone. Now it's onto the headband. So for the headband, you're going to have the leather, whatever fabric you choose, two clamps, two covers, and four screws, and of course the main spring. So what you want to do is prepare the headband just by putting these little clamps on and getting the screws through them. You can do this by hand or use your Phillips number one to do that. And you can see I'm just getting that through the leather. Whoops. You can even put the screws on the clamps first and then line them up properly on the leather. Just like that. There. And again. Just like that. And then what you do is you tuck that into the holes on the headband. Just like that. Till the screws poke through. And then you line that up with the holes inside the covers. and then screw that in. And that'll clamp the leather to this outer cover with this clamp in the middle. And now we can do the other side. So again, you just get those screws through the holes in the headband, in the spring. There we go. Oh, missed it. Till the screws pop out. And fasten your cover onto the headband and tighten them down. Just like that. Now we can bring our cones back and just slide them onto the headband. Just like that. Make sure that the XLR are facing the same direction. There we go. So once you've mounted your cones, you're ready to put your cable in. And that's easy. They're labeled left and right. And so all we need to do is put the right in the right, the left in the left. So congratulations. You now built your very own set of Head Amame headphones. They're going to sound amazing, and we can't wait for you to listen to them. And we'll make you a deal. If you post them on social media and tag us, we'll ship you your very own serial number to go on the side of it. You can mount them on there, show off to your friends what number you got, and we'll send that to you free of charge. You just give us your address, and you'll get it. If you haven't already seen the slicing guide for the Head Amame files, you can click the link here. Don't forget to lick a comment and make sure you survive.